For weeks, we've been following the story of a hit and run in Buffalo and a family's demand for answers. Well, today, for the first time, we got to take our questions to prosecutors. Good evening. I'm Mary Alice Demler.
And I'm Pete Gallivan. And also, for the first time, we know that the authorities do have a suspect in this case. Two on your side's Claudine Ewing went to get answers from the district attorney today. Claudine?
Good evening, Pete. The main question the family has is why no action yet? The DA says this case is a high priority, and he explains what's been happening so far.
When Will Jones was finishing up work and driving home early on June 26, his car was struck by someone driving a Dodge. Jones was critically injured. The other driver fled on foot. The family wants to know why, after 2 months, the driver has not been caught. More upsetting, the Buffalo police report that says a male was inside a Harlow Place home but would not come to the door to speak with police.
Shouldn't you not just sit on the house or get a warrant?
Well, they can't force him to answer questions.
So basically they needed to get him getting out of the car.
Well, they either needed to get him getting out of the car.
And according to the family, there was an eyewitness.
They saw a black male flee. Yes.
Well, it's 4 o'clock in the morning. How many people are walking the street?
No, I agree.
But the DA says the man seen leaving the scene is a suspect.
The suspect has been questioned and is being uncooperative. So now we are going to plan B, which is we are in the forensic analysis mode of the investigation.
If the forensics match the suspect, expect an arrest.
Is there a concern that he would leave town?
Perhaps, but I mean, again, until the DNA evidence comes back, there's nothing we can hold him on. Unless we get a positive ID on him.
Jones remains hospitalized. He is now able to talk.
Why the person will keep running and keep going and not face up to what happened.
He has a long recovery. At one point, his future was in jeopardy. He's the publisher of Black WNY, a magazine that focuses on positive stories in Buffalo. His family says the person responsible for the accident needs to be held accountable.
I don't want to see the man crucified or anything like that. I just want him to own up to what he did.
The district attorney says this case was on his desk 2 days after the accident. Coming up at 6 o'clock, hear more from the DA on why hit-and-run cases are so difficult to tackle for police as well as prosecutors. Claudine Ewing, Channel 2 News.